We're going to talk about a technique with a tool called a rake. Now, before I go any further, you know, some people are going to say, okay, that's not a rake, that's a comb, or that's a chisel. It makes no difference. The sounds that come out of my mouth to describe something are going to be entirely different than other people's sounds make to describe something. The important thing is that you remember that when you need to do this technique, you know what tool to use, and it comes into your mind no matter what sounds come out of your mouth to describe it. And a rake is used primarily for making grass, fur, or hair. There are all sizes and there are all types. And I'm going to give a demonstration, but I wanted to show you some of the tools that are available to do this. These are tools and rakes. Right. This is a rake. Now, a lot of people call this a fan. Well, yeah, but a fan is entirely different than a fan rake. When I wet this down, you're going to see that it separates a lot. It's very thin. A fan is used for blending. We use this to make fur, grass, hair, or some other long techniques. Okay, and they come in all sizes. They come in this size, they come in a smaller size. Some people cut them down to make them more linear. I don't do that, it's too expensive. These are expensive brushes. Okay. Here's another one. And I want you to see it. Look how coarse that is. That's like a yard rake, really. When you look at it, pretty good size. They come in different sizes also. Okay, here's the most common of the rakes. You can barely see the rake feature in it, which means that you have to be careful on the pressure that you use when you use these type of tools. Pressure is important. Push hard, forget it. You're not going to get the technique that this thing was designed for. You push too light, of course the paint don't come off. Now let me show you what I mean by this. This is a rake. And you look at it and you see how narrow it is. This is a flat. It's a lot thicker. You can use this like this, or you can use it like this. And I'm going to show you some techniques with this. We're going to make some grass. I'm not going to make fur and hair and stuff. You can do that on your own. We're going to talk about grass, and I'm going to show you how I make grass on this thing, all this back here, everything in the background was done with a rake. Okay, I'll get up close and we'll talk about it, and then I'll bring a small sheet of watercolor paper in here, and we'll talk about
before grass. We get into showing the strokes with a rake. I want to show you a couple of alternatives if you can't get a rake brush. One of them is you get a flat, regular flat brush. You squeeze the end of it until it starts to splay out. Put some paint on it. Splay it out. And then do your strokes. There you have it. Grass, fur, whatever you want. I don't like using it because I can't hold the brush the way I want to. I prefer to hold my brushes out here at the end. Not up here. Not up here in the front. Okay. Another alternative, which I use, is old cheap ragged brushes. Look how bad a shape that is. But it does work well for making grass-like strokes and fur-like strokes. And then, of course, some people really like to get small and do single strokes. You can do that too. That takes a long time. I notice there's a lot of similarity in the strokes there. But let's use the rakes. I'm going to show them to you again, one by one. This is a pretty good size one. Actually, they call this a chisel also. And we'll show you the various types of strokes. You can do short strokes. You can do long strokes. You can do loose strokes. And you can do tight strokes. Again, remember, pressure is important. Let's do it with real light pressure first. You see the kind of lines I do. Now let's press a little harder. Okay, and that's the line you get. Alright. Let's do some short strokes. Okay, and let's get really loose. Some long strokes. This one, I like this one. You see what it does. Right, that's a pretty coarse rake. And they come in different sizes like that also. There's a small one. Small one. And it's pretty coarse. I'm not going to do strokes with that. It's the same as that one. Okay. Let's look at the fan rakes. Got a large one, a small one. And again, why they're not for blending is because you can see there's not that many bristles. There's a lot of space between the bristles. They're very thin. A blending fan has a lot of bristles. It's very soft. Let's see what this one does here. Okay. Let's do a long stroke with this one. Okay. That was a light long stroke. Let's do one a little bit heavier. You can see you want to distribute your paint sort of equally. I didn't do this with the thick chisel because you can do it with a brush. Let's do a long stroke and see what happens. This is what's suitable for loose strokes. This one you do it the long way. Okay. Let's do a couple of really loose strokes with this. Short. Let's do short ones first. You can see that there's a lot closer together. Now let's do some loose stuff here. But you can see the effect here. But I'll not use the big one. It looks the same, just covers more area. These are traditional rakes. This is a flat. Again, let me show you how much thinner so you can get a better idea. This is a rake. This is a flat. You can see the difference in the thickness. But since all these rakes, these flat rakes, were pretty much the same, I'll just use one and we'll look at those techniques. Or the strokes with that. I'll try and distribute the paint a little more evenly across here. Again, pressure is important. You press lightly, you get nice light lines in there. This is because I don't have my paint properly distributed on there. I'm going to distribute it properly now, the way it's supposed to be, and do that again. Just a hard stroke. And see what happens when you press hard. Let me do a lighter one now. Let me get that thing in there even. Let's do some short ones. And you can see that it'll work well on grass. I like the flatness the best. Let's get a little bit looser now. You can see it, and that was a hard stroke. Pressure is very important with this. Little light touch. That worked well. Jiggly line. Want some more little jiggly lines. You can do all kinds of things with this. Okay, now let's do one more stroke with it this way. See, it works like a flat. I'm going to do some grass upwards. And it works well. Let's do a little bit of grass here. A bit long stems on it. Let's do some of the short grass. Press hard and loosen up. Press hard, loosen up. Loosen up, press hard. You get all kinds of different techniques. This is your rakes. These are the kind of strokes you get out of it. And you can use other substitutes for it. And this is really how I like using my brushes, way back here. And it works a lot better for me. You notice how many strokes I've done with this, which is one brush load, quite a bit. Okay, you find a rake. Give it a try. You know, you'll probably have pretty good success with fur and hair and other things.